Hello students, welcome back you all. Today we are going to study about the two most important things or the essential things in our life. Without these we won't be able to live, and these things are air and water. So let us start chapter 8, air and water. In this session we will discuss about the most important or the most essential thing for our life, that is air. So let us start with this session. First of all, we have to discuss the introduction about air and water. As you know that the two most important things without which we want to able to live are air and water. You know, the air was all around us in our environment. We take it in when we breathe, means we take it in our body every time, every second we breathe. And this air consists primarily of two main gases, oxygen and nitrogen, in addition to small amounts of other gases like bacteria, viruses, etc. It's a mixture of several gases. So air is colorless and odorless and tasteless, and is made up of about 78% of nitrogen, 21% of oxygen, and 1% is composed of small quantities of other gases. Other gases such as hydrogen, helium, carbon dioxide, etc. So always remember that air is a mixture of gases which is surrounding the earth surface. And we cannot see it, but we can feel air. So let us study about all the major gases in detail. Okay, so the first one is oxygen. Oxygen is a colorless gaseous element, and 21% of atmosphere constitutes oxygen. So oxygen is 21%, and which is essential for all living beings, and it is also essential for burning. So oxygen is important to us in many ways. Okay, now let us move on to the another gas, the major constituent of the atmosphere, and that is nitrogen. So nitrogen is the most abundant element in our planet's atmosphere, that means in our earth atmosphere. So 78% of the atmosphere is comprised of nitrogen. And also it is important to plant life. And there are 1% of other gases like argon, hydrogen, helium, carbon dioxide, etc. that present in air. These all gases are present in the air. So argon is colorless and odorless gas, and it is used in making light bulbs and fluorescent tubes. So carbon dioxide is used by green plants to make their own food. Besides the mixture of gases, air contains water vapor and dust particles in it. Now we studied about the air composition. Let us see the air composition in pie chart. We know that air surrounds us in a mixture of several gases. Several means many gases. So here blue one shows the nitrogen. Blue one shows nitrogen, that means 78% of nitrogen is present in the atmosphere. Secondly, red one. The red one, that is 21% of oxygen. So 21% of oxygen is present in the atmosphere. Then rest of the green color shows the 1% of other gases. This is the 78 plus 21 means 99%. So out of 100, 99 has been constituted by which gases? Nitrogen and oxygen. Okay, so now we studied about the air composition. Let us discuss something about our atmosphere. We know that air forms a layer around the earth. This layer is called atmosphere, earth atmosphere.
So what is atmosphere? Atmosphere is the layer which forms air around the earth. So the first layer of the atmosphere is made up of gases that we breathe. And that layer we discussed right now. So this layer is called a troposphere. So there are 5 layers of atmosphere. Atmosphere have 5 layers. They are troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere and exosphere. So the troposphere is the first layer that we live in. And this layer is made up of the gases that we breathe. The next layer of our atmosphere is called the stratosphere. So after troposphere comes stratosphere. Above the stratosphere lies the mesosphere. Then it followed by the thermosphere. Then finally exosphere. So exosphere is actually present at very very top place. That means the top layer. So this is the last layer which is very very high. So stratosphere is the second layer of the atmosphere and aircrafts fly in this region. And ozone layer also present here. So we know that ozone layer protects our earth from ultraviolet rays. Okay. So stratosphere protects our earth from ultraviolet rays because ozone layer is present here. And the third layer is mesosphere. It lies above the stratosphere. It is about 50 to 80 kilometer above the earth's surface. Then thermosphere. It is the fourth layer of the atmosphere and it extends 90 to 500 kilometers above the earth. And it lies above which layer? Mesosphere. Okay, so thermosphere is the fourth layer of the atmosphere. Then last one, exosphere. Exosphere is the outermost layer of the earth extending up to thousands of kilometers. So little amount of air is present in this layer and it is very very high from the earth. So these all are the layers of atmosphere. So atmosphere have 5 layers. They are troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere and exosphere. So students, I hope you all clear about or all clear with air composition and atmosphere. And you enjoyed this session. So we will meet in the next session and we will learn more about the air and atmosphere. Till then, keep learning, keep enjoying. Thank you.